We all have our favorite musicians who have passed on, but since he moved here from Los Angeles via Austin, Texas, Ron Rogers has found that his coffin memorials for his favorite blues, rock, and R&B musicians are in great demand. Having trouble picturing what a Ron Rogers coffin memorial might be? Take a look at these.
Well, I'm gonna wait to leave. Won't be back no more. Going back down south, child, don't you wanna go? Woman, I'm trouble.
Oh, baby, let me be your soldier dog. I'm gonna be your man, oh, baby.
I wanna... Ain't it hard?
This don't have no mercy in this land.
This is the first one Ron made. It's Professor Longhair, the great New Orleans pianist, who put the rumba beat to the blues, and out came a sound that has resonated for nearly 60 years.
Tipitina.
I went to New Orleans and I went down there and it just seemed to be a lot of primitive type art and just appealed to me as opposed to fine art. I went into this record store, a local record store there, and they had these, somebody had made a little box out of popsicle sticks and they'd stuck a couple little skeleton figures made out of paper in there, and they had one guy at the piano and it said Professor Longhair, and I asked, and they had it hanging behind the counter. I said, "What's that?" And the guy said, "Oh, I don't know. This guy just makes them here in town, makes of his favorite musicians." I thought, "Well, that's a cool idea." So I just kind of, you know, took it from there. Most of the time I do blues musicians, but there's some 60s guys like Hendrix and Jerry Garcia and Janis Joplin. I've done them. I did John Lennon. It's one of my favorites. I thought there's an interesting thing that's happened with the... What I'm going to paint under here is Voodoo Child, C-H-I-L-E. And all the reissues that have been coming out, on the, they say Voodoo Child. They actually misspell it. If you go back to Electric Ladyland, it's C-H-I-L-E.
Ron came to Portland from Los Angeles about a year ago with his wife, and from Austin, Texas before that. His icons have made quite a splash since he got here. There are some of them at the Music Millennium store in Northeast Portland, at the Acadia restaurant, and Ron did a lot of work at that adorable little five-stool downtown carryout shop, Mardi Gras Kitchen. You wouldn't think that before he got to Oregon, Ron's life was wall-to-wall music.
My wife and I had a band. She was the lead singer. I wrote the songs. We got a Billboard. We put out our independent album and we sent it to Billboard, and we got an album of the week pick. And all these record companies called us, and so Island came to see us play, and they were going to sign us to a record deal, and our manager screwed it up, and the band broke up, but I got a publishing deal, and the guy that signed me was out of London, and I lived in Austin, Texas, and that's a hard connection to make. So I was on staff for 2 years, but nothing really happened. But it was a good experience, and I made some money. You know, I mean, it sustained me a little bit. And that's the story.
Lately, Ron has been making house blessings. A little voodoo, a little Day of the Dead.
I've always dug skulls and Day of the Dead stuff. Being from Texas, I was exposed to a lot of Day of the Dead and the whole skull thing. I start out with clay, and I make the skull out of clay. And this is some stuff called Sculpty that you can cook in the oven. And I cook it in the oven, and then I lay it out in a box form like this. I make a box out of poster board, and I go buy this silicone, and I put those skulls down in there, and then I pour the silicone around it. And then after it sets up overnight, the skulls pop out, and I've got my mold, and then I mix up this stuff with this Hydra stone, and then I just pour it in to the mold like so. And then in about 20 minutes, the skulls pop out. You know, you'd be surprised how many people say to me when they see what I do, they say, well, you know, if you got 3 or 4 people, you could start an assembly line and you could be cranking those coffins out. And I'm like, it's not art anymore after you do that. Why do I want to do that? It's like, hey, you know, man, what grin would I get out of that? Thing I do is I take some Spanish moss and wrap it in some appropriate material. I usually just go to a second-hand clothing store and buy some, you know, woman's blouse from the 80s. Then I just take some of this jute and just wrap this. And I'm ready to put the skulls on it. There you go.
As well as Ron has been doing with his art, he is, after all, a lifelong musician, and he's found some folks here in town to play with, although they haven't played publicly yet.
Do you identify more as a musician or an artist now?
I'm just both. I mean, I'll never stop playing music, but, you know, trying to make a living playing music is a bitch. I mean, it's hard to do.
I asked my doctor for the answer. He said, you're probably gonna die of cancer. And my fiance told me yesterday that she wants to be a topless dancer. Well, I'm a slave boy in a world gone wild.
But the art's just fun. I think I do something that's kind of unique, and so people are drawn to it, and so I've gotten some strokes. And so, you know, whenever you get strokes, it's great. You know, you're like, oh, well, I'll keep doing this. I'm getting strokes.